Okay. Hello, everybody. So thank you for inviting me to the Jam Developer Meetup. So I'm going to talk about stochastic decomposition applied to energy system management, especially large-scale systems. Oh, is it working? It didn't sense.
Do we have the clock? Is it working now?
Yeah. Oh, thanks. So what we will study is this kind of system. Imagine you have a distribution network with several buildings connected to this network. And what you want to do is to take each building separately, in fact, to split the network in several parts, solve each part apart, and then try to coordinate the different sub-problems together to find a global optimum. And as we consider energy systems, in each building, you will have demands and production, e.g., solar panels, that kind of stuff. So each node problem is formulated as a stochastic programming problem, as a multi-stage stochastic problem, as we'll consider problem over one day horizon, for instance. So what we want to do here is to consider such large-scale problem that formulate on a graph, to apply decomposition algorithm on it, and then to solve them by using Julia and Jump. So let's first talk about the model we will use. We will consider a network oriented and connected. And we'll consider flows through the edges and are arriving at each node. The flow at the nodes and the flow at the edges are connected together via the Kirchhoff law, which means that if we consider the node incidence arc, the node edge incidence matrix A, they are related by AQ plus F equals zero for all time T we consider. And as we have a multi-stage problem, we consider also a problem with different time steps, arising from time zero till time T final, that is the horizon. So if we consider a one-day horizon problem at a 15-minute time step, that gives big T equal 96. So that's quite a big problem to deal with. So that's the formulation we will adapt to model our problem. We want to minimize operational cost, denoted by L, over our one-day horizon. So we want to decrease the expected value of the cost, operational cost plus a final cost to penalize the final position of our devices. At each node, we will consider also stocks. That is, we can have battery, hot water tank that have a time couplings across the different time steps that will be denoted by G. So the states at time T is related to the state at time t plus 1 by this relation. We'll consider also a non-anticipatory constraint, which means that at time t, I take a decision, but I cannot anticipate the future. I can only consider the past realization of the noise. That's right as an algebraic constraint. And eventually, I have to consider the load balance equation. At each time t, I want that the prediction is equal to the demand in all nodes in my graph. That was the problem on the nodes. Now, we consider the problem on the edges. The problem is way more simplified because we will consider only a quadratic penalization for the flow through the edges. This quadratic penalization could be, for instance, energy losses, being by joule losses, through the different arcs, as we consider the distribution network. So now let's gather the two problems. We consider the global cost on nodes that we denote by GV. Then we consider the global cost on edge. And what we want to do is to minimize the cost on nodes plus the cost on edge by satisfying the coupling constraints which correspond to the Kirchhoff current law. Is it clear? So that's the problem we will deal with. As you can see here, we have two main problems, the problem on nodes and the problem on edge, and a unique coupling constraint. So what we want to do, in fact, is to decouple these coupling constraints by using decomposition techniques, like price or resource decomposition. And then we will apply our two algorithms, price and resource decomposition, again, on problem corresponding to distribution network. And we will see that our problem scale to problem with up to 48 buildings, that is, with a state with dimension 90 or 100 state variable, which is quite huge for a stochastic, a multi-stage stochastic problem. Because usually, classical technical methods like SDDP are confronted to the famous curse of dimensionality, and they cannot solve problems with up to 20 state variables. So here we are reaching problem with 100 state variables. So let's start about price and resource decomposition. How can you decompose the problem by using price decomposition? In fact, we'll consider three layers of management. The first layer, the global manager or the central planner, will fix a price, lambda, and then you will send this price to each building in the graph. Then the buildings, you consider the price, hey, cool, I have a price, so I have to consider this price and to manage my different stocks and production means in my buildings, so as to minimize my operational cost plus the penalization induced by the price given by the central planner. And as we consider multi-stage stochastic optimization problem in each building, we will solve each problem in each building here by using dynamic programming technique. That is, we will compute value function time step by steps in a backward way. So that's the problem of the central planner. The central planner wants to find the saddle point of this problem. So we will iterate by using, for instance, a user algorithm till it finds the optimal prices. As you can see, once you fix a price, you are able to decompose the problem node by node, or buildings by buildings. By rewriting the problem like that, we obtain completely independent subproblems at nodes. So you just have to consider the price at each node and solve this problem. Then each node sends back a solution, and you can iterate, you can compute a gradient, and iterate to find the next price to consider, and that till convergence. Then at each node, we consider this problem. So we want to minimize our operational cost plus the prices dot the importation flow F. And as you can see, this problem is a multi-stage stochastic optimization problem which formulates like that. The only difference between the precedent problem is that you have the following cost here. And as it is a multi-stage stochastic problem, again, we are able to solve it by dynamic programming. Then, once you have computed the value function, you are able to compute the optimal flow by Monte Carlo techniques, as here we deal with expected value. So that was just to describe how we compute the different value functions. So let's emphasize the fact that each value function are local. So they are quite small comparing to the global value function of the problem. For instance, they lie in a dimension 1 or 2, whereas the global value function of the problem has dimension 48, 100, and so on. So that's quite more easy to solve this value function than the global value function. We break apart the curse of dimensionality. And then we are able to apply, if provided that the price process is Markovian, because we have to recover the classical assumption of dynamic programming, we are able to compute each value function by this backward equation. That is, we consider the cost item t plus 1, and we want to minimize the current cost plus the cost induced by the prices sent by the central planner plus the cost to go vt plus 1. And the main advantage is that this problem formulates as a LP or a QP problems. So they're quite easy to solve, for instance, with Gear OB. Okay, so we talk about price decomposition, So what about resource allocation? It's exactly the same principle, but you don't fix the price. Rather, you will fix allocation. So you will fix an allocation at each node of your graph, and you will write two problems corresponding to the production problem and the transport problem. As you can see here, you deal with a constraint writing IQ plus R equals 0. So you have to ensure that R is in the image of the node edge incidence matrix R. So if the graph is connected, that induces that the sum of the different components of R are equal to 0. Then, again, we are able to solve such a problem by using a gradient algorithm with the update state writing like that. The main advantage is that we use two decomposition techniques, price and resource decomposition, and we are able to prove that these decomposition techniques give an upper and a lower bound for the optimal value of the problem. It's quite easy to prove. One results lie on the fact that the allocation is admissible, so the upper bound is straightforward, and the other results rely on weak duality. I will talk more about it at ECMP next week. Okay, so we have two decomposition techniques. We are able to find the optimal price or the optimal resources and to solve each subproblem by dynamic programming. Then, we are able to fetch back the different value functions computed by dynamic programming on each local node and to build a global policies that is admissible. And by using these two policies induced by the price and the resource decomposition, we'll be able to control to take decisions at each type steps in our problem by using the central planner. That is, at each type step, once I have computed my value function, I'm able to solve this problem. That is, I want to minimize the global operational cost at time t plus the future cost to go at each node of the graph, considering the different coupling constraints, that is the dynamics, the load balance equation, and my Kirchhoff law, IQ plus F equals zero. And this policy is admissible. Okay, so we have a problem. We have different algorithms to solve it. So let's do some numerics. We'll consider a problem with growing size. First, we'll tackle a three-node problem, which is quite simple to solve, even with classical techniques like SDDP. And we will consider a growing number of nodes up to 48 nodes. We'll consider the distribution network looking like that. We will consider a one-day horizon at 15-minute time steps, and we will consider also a sunny day in Paris. That is a day which is quite similar like today. The weather is hot and sunny, so the production of the solar panels will be nominal. And we will consider different kinds of buildings in our network. We will consider buildings with one battery and one electrical hot water tank. So you are able to store electricity either in the battery or in the electrical hot water tank by heating the water inside. Other buildings will have solar panels, and other will have only electrical hot water tank. So we have heterogeneous dynamics inside each building. And we suppose that all people are benevolent. We do not have initiator. So all people want to share their energy together. It's like an hippie community, I don't know. Okay, so how can we compute the price and also the composition? In fact, we saw that price and also the composition are similar to a gradient-like algorithm. So what do we want to use here is, you all know that the gradient algorithm is quite slow to converge, so we will use BFGS, that is second order method, to find our optimal prices or resources. So the update, for instance, for the price will look like that, with W, the matrix which mimics the Hessian of the problem. Then we iterate till no direction descent is found, and then the algorithm stops. As you can see, we split the problem node by nodes. So at each node, we will solve the dynamic programming equation by SDDP. As the problem has low dimension, SDDP will be fast to converge. And then we estimate, of course, the different gradient by Monte Carlo. And when we compare our two decomposition method with a global SDP method applied globally to the problem. That is, we will consider the 48-knot problem. We will simplify it and then solve it by SDP. Which is, in fact, I don't know if everybody knows SDP, but it's a reference method in stochastic programming. We choose cutting plane to approximate a value function. So what we're going to do, in fact, is to first resample the support of the noise, because the noise, the global noise is too big to deal with in SDP. So we will use quantization algorithm to resample the noise, effectively. Then we will call SDP and solve the global problem. To accelerate the convergence, we'll use a level one cut selection algorithm with cutpruner.gl to keep only the 100 most relevant cuts. And we will stop SDP once the gap between the upper and the lower bound is below 1%. So as you can see, we also deal with problems with quite a large size. So what I do not want to do is to write the dynamics, the global dynamics of my problems, component by component. So I use a little bit some metaprogramming technique to pass the device in each house, that is, hey, give me the dynamics of the battery as an expression, give me the dynamics of the hot water tank as an expression. I will gather these two expressions and build a dynamic vector. That allows me to build a lambda function which corresponds to the dynamics of the building. Then, to build the dynamic of the global problem, I just have to concatenate the dynamics of all buildings in my graph together and build a lambda function corresponding to the global dynamics of the system. So by using this metaprogramming technique, I am able to build a global dynamics and a global cost without writing each dynamics component by component. Okay, that was for the model. For the different algorithm, in fact, I am relying on the JuliaHop community. So I'll solve the BFGS algorithm by using IPOPT.gl. I will solve each node sub-problems by using SDP algorithm implemented in the package stochdynamicprogramming.gl. And then I will solve each one-step problem in dynamic programming by using Gurubi.gl. So free JuliaHopped package. As you can see, SDP converge fairly well, in fact, for the 12-knot problem. But for problem with a larger number of nodes, SDP will be quite slow to converge. But as you can see, for the 12-knot problem, it's okay. I mean, around 200 iterations, we can consider that SDP has converged. And that's for the convergence of BFGS. So we illustrate we have 96 multipliers associated to the first node of the problem. So we just plot against the iteration, the evolution of each multiplier. So as you can see, the multipliers start to stabilize around 20 iterations. And then I have a stopping criterion in IPOPT, which tells, hey, okay, you can stop. It's fair. The accuracy is fair enough. So SDP converge, but fail to converge for bigger problem. Fail to converge well, but we can still run SDP on a bigger problem. And our decomposition method converge for all problem. So that's the result we obtain. So I know that's quite a large table, so let's focus just on some results. First, we compare the upper and the lower bound given by each algorithm. As you can see here, the lower bound given by SDP is lower than the lower bound given by decomposition method. So the decomposition method are better to estimate the lower bound. That was the first result. Then we obtain an upper bound with our resource decomposition techniques. But this upper bound is not that good. It is quite far from the optimal value of the problem, which is closer to the lower bound given by the price decomposition method. That was because, by considering that the resources are Markovian, it was too much a simplification for the resource decomposition algorithm. As you can see also, if we consider the 38 knots problem, we can see that SDP converge in, I don't know, in a few 450 minutes. Whereas the diffusion algorithm converge in 120 minutes and 1 hour and 30 minutes. So our decomposition techniques are faster than SDP for large-scale problems. That's another result we have to consider. We saw also that we are able to build admissible policies. So we consider the admissible policies given back by price decomposition, resource decomposition, and SDP. Then we will estimate the average cost obtained by these strategies by using Monte Carlo techniques. And that allows us to compare the different strategies induced by each algorithm. So for the free knots problem, the SDP strategy is better than the price policy and the resource policy. But if you consider growing number of knots, the larger the problem, the better are the strategy induced by price and resource decomposition. And we have the price policy beats SDP by up to 1.7% for the 38 knots problem. So we have algorithms that converge faster and which give better results in simulation. So here we are quite happy. So to conclude, we have presented two decomposition algorithms in a stochastic programming framework and see that by fixing a price on a resource, we are allowed to iterate through this price and resource till an optimal multiplier and optimal resource found. Then we are able to fetch back the value function and build global policy that we can use in simulation as they are admissible. And we saw that price and resource decomposition are better than the classical SDP algorithm for large-scale problems, either in terms of convergence or in terms of policies. They give a better precision. So what we want to do now is to use parallelization because the parallelization of price and resource decomposition is straightforward. In fact, I have some problem with the lambda function, which are quite difficult to define on all process, but that's a problem I hope to deal with this summer. You can also consider, we saw here only nodal decomposition, but we can also decompose the problem in zonal, in different zones. For instance, we'll gather buildings 3x3, and then solve a problem corresponding to 3 buildings instead of 1 building. Maybe that could give better results than a simple nodal decomposition. And we want also to extend this study to other decomposition algorithms. In fact, we consider only the two classical decomposition methods, that is price and resource decomposition. But we are also able to deal with more complicated decomposition methods that's relying on operator splitting method. For instance, Joachim presented to us yesterday the algorithm of Chambal and Poc, so it's more like a primal dual algorithm. And we are able to adapt this algorithm to solve such problems. So you can see price decomposition as a dual algorithm, resource decomposition as a dual algorithm. Now we want to mix the primal and dual algorithm together to build primal dual techniques. And we want also to adapt a proximal method to such problem in a stochastic settings. So thank you for your attention. And if you have any questions, I'm here to answer them.